everyone, I'm Neeraj, part of Kepro open source platform, working as a cloud infrastructure lead. Today, we are going to discuss about CRUD operation in DynamoDB. It means it will create, read, update and delete operation we will do in DynamoDB. So let's start. So the course outline we are going to discuss about what are the tool for the CRUD operation in DynamoDB. We'll create, read, update, delete using Python code with Lambda in DynamoDB table and the lab on it. So when we discuss about a database and we see database operation, the one thing always comes in the mind, how we have to communicate to the database. So if you have worked with the other database, MySQL, SQL Server and Oracle database, you have an SQL developer, you have SQL plus utility, there are a lot of utility you can communicate with a database using a graphical interface, Toad, all. But in the DynamoDB, you have only seen in my previous video, I have using the AWS management console to communicate within DynamoDB. Apart from that, in DynamoDB tables, you always have to communicate through the code written in any language which it supports. Means that the very first, DynamoDB is a development database or developer database, you can see. Apart from AWS console, there is no direct way to communicate within DynamoDB. You always have to communicate through code, or you can communicate through CLI command line for the AWS. Let's see. Sorry. So the tool to use to access the DynamoDB table are using the console. We have seen that using CLI command, AWS command line, or API. You can create API using a different code, okay, as well as IP address range. Using the IP address range also, you can access your DynamoDB. But the mostly use this first three. Either you can use console, that is for a specific purpose, but mostly we use CLI command line or API code. Like using a code only, we people do all the CRUD operation in the DynamoDB. So DynamoDB, the language support, you can have a Java shell script, you have Node.js with DynamoDB, we have a PHP with DynamoDB, you can write your code with a Ruby and attached to the DynamoDB, and Python with a DynamoDB. The most famous and mostly people use either a JavaScript, that is for SDK, or Node.js, or Python. This first two and the last is most famous. I mean, frequently people use that. What we are going to discuss about is what we are going to use a Python script for all the DynamoDB tables. So using the command line or using command AWS, CLI, Python code, or using Lambda. So I will show you in two different ways, from the command line and using the Lambda. What is Lambda? We'll discuss. So suppose I have written kept the code, because if you go and write one by one, it will take a lot of time. So you can write your Python code and you can run the Python code locally. Locally means from my local machine, I can run the Python code from command line. So the code will update the DynamoDB table. Number one, same Python code, the slightly change, with some extra module is required. Same Python code, we can put in the Lambda and tell the Lambda to run that, and the Lambda will execute the Python code, and the same thing will get updated in the DynamoDB. So what is Lambda? Lambda is a tool or a service provided by AWS to run your code. It doesn't need any infrastructure. What does it mean? Means that I will explain you in a layman language. Like suppose you have your application running in a server one, am I right? And you can't run your code to test it on the server one, and you want to configure something for the application which is running in a server one from outside the server. So what you will do? You will need another server. The server has a proper communication to the server one where your application is running. Then you can write your, suppose you have to write a Python code, you have to write a Python code, you have to install all the Python library on the server two. Then while writing communicated, you have to check that communication is okay or not on the Python code, or sorry, on the server one, and then you will run the code. So the code will run from the Python server 2 and connect to the server 1 and then execute the things. Replicate the same thing in your cloud environment. Suppose one application is running on a EC2 server and you have to do some operational work. You want to schedule, but you don't want to touch the server 1, the EC2 server 1. What you will do? Simply, you will launch a EC2 server, another EC2 server. You will write your code, you will download all the Python, write the code and check from the server, second EC2 server, the primary EC2 server is able to communicate or not. All you will do this and then you will run the code. So what will happen in that? You have to pay for the EC2 server where you have kept your code. That is important. And secondly, when the execution will happen, the data transfer will happen, for that also you have to pay. To remove all this, the lambda, what it will do is you put your code and tell that I want to execute on a Python. You select it, you execute it, it will execute it internally. It will launch the EC2 server and all, and you have to pay only during the execution time. Whatever the execution time the script got executed, you have to pay for that only. You don't have to pay for holes on another server. That's the biggest achievement in the Lambda. So we'll see that. Sorry. So what we are going to do is we are going to create a table. We are going to load a data, insert. Then we'll select the data, how to select. Then we'll update the record. Then we'll delete the record. Then we'll do the batch load, like how more than one record can be executed. We'll create a loop. Creating a loop is, you might have seen like when you do some development testing and all in a SQL Server or in Oracle, what you does? If you have to test with a table where 10,000 record, you don't go for looking for 10,000 sample record. You just create a loop. So 10,000 record will get generated and it will inserted in the table. Similarly, we'll see that how we can create a loop for the DynamoDB table. Then we'll query with the key columns, we'll scan the table and we'll delete the table. We are going to do in the lab. So let's go. First is, so before going to lab, what I'm doing is I'm trying to run AWS command line, and using the command line first I will, just a sec. From the command line, I will run the command, because I told you, you can run through two way, either the Python code or AWS CLI also, it has a lot of command, you can create it. And before that, your local machine should have AWS CLI installed as well as Boto. That is, what is Boto? I will tell you. Boto is nothing. You just go here, you can type what is Boto 3. So Boto 3 is a client which allow AWS to communicate with the Python. If you are a developer and you work with a Python, there is another module to communicate with an Oracle, that is called Oracle CX. Similarly, Boto is nothing extra, it's just a client which communicate with a software API to the Python. That's all. And you have to install, like you have to type in Google, it's very easy. Install AWS CLI plus Boto. So you will get it. I'm installing CLI command line. Or you can type with the PIP. So there is a single command that will help you to install your PIP as well as AWS. So this is the way you can install this. Okay. How to install AWS CLI using Python and PIP on the window, you can install that. I have just shown you for your help. So we'll go to here the command line, and I have already installed my AWS CLI, Python and Boto, as well as you have to create a user. It should have a administrative access or access to create a DynamoDB, and the user should have generated with a key and secret key ID. And that's, if you go and check my IAM policy and IAM user, you will come to know how to create a user with access key and secret access key. So that I have already created. So what I will do is, we have a very simple command, aws configure, and this is the username. I think it's the same, but just for your sake I'm repeating it again. And this is, see, that is important. Okay, why that is important, I will show you. This default region, and even US is one like North Virginia. So whatever the command you will run to create a table, the table will get created in that region only. Okay, so you have to keep in the mind. Now, so create a table will use this command. I will update all the commands. I will give a link, don't bother about, you will get all the command. After subscription, the link will be present, you can download it from there. So see this, AWS DynamoDB, oh sorry, it got created. So AWS DynamoDB create hyphen table is a syntax, then table name, it's a music, attribute, definitions, attribute name. See, it's very important. When you create a DynamoDB table, you might have seen in a console also, you have to define a primary key as well as a short key. Even if you don't define a short key, without primary key you cannot create a table. Similar things is present in here also in command line, AWS DynamoDB create table, table name, music, attribute definitions, attribute name artist, which type of, it's a string, attribute name song title, and attribute type is s, means a string, key schema that is defined, and you can also define provision, throughput, read capacity, write capacity unit that we have already discussed. How we can check that it has been created? We can check if table is AWS DynamoDB. Table names, EMP one that is already created, and the music. So you can use the command line also, AWS command line, to create your DynamoDB table. The most important is you can update this metadata also, like if you want to update the provision capacity from 10 to 20, it will done. How you can check that? You can describe the metadata. How to AWS dynamic table, table name, music, describe table. So now if you go through the describe table, see this, read capacity is now 20. When it was created with a 10, we have updated the metadata, now it is 20. So this way you can communicate with the DynamoDB table. The most important, now we are going to discuss about it through the Python code, because I have mostly AWS command line is maybe for the testing purpose, but mostly people use code that are in Python or JavaScript and all. So I have written a Python code and we'll go one by one. So how you have to install Python and all, I'm not going to discuss, but yes, you remember, you have run, if you're not setting the environmental variable, to try to run the code from where your Python is installed. So if you put where Python, it will give as a script, and this is the window applications. So this is what is for window application, so we can leave it. Now we'll go to our Python code. First is create a table. So import Boto3. Whenever any code, if you are writing for the DynamoDB table, you have to write code, and the code is says import Boto3, and then you put DynamoDB is equal to Boto3 dot which resource DynamoDB. So if you go in a Google and if you put DynamoDB plus Boto3 documentation, you will come to know, like, first we have to import the Boto3, then you have to type Dynamo. This up to this is very similar. Any code you will get this first two line. Like in shell script, you this that hash colon bin bash, either a ksh or sh script. Similarly, the import Boto3 DynamoDB is equal to Boto3 dot resource DynamoDB. This two line is always present when you write a Python code which you want to run from your local machine. That is a bit important, local machine. Now table is equal to create DynamoDB dot create table is a package. Then the table name, that is important, and key schema. Once you define the key schema, what is the key attribute name, employee ID, key type hash, and range. Hash means it's a primary key, range means it's a short key. So I have created with an employee ID. Very important, this syntax is case sensitive. If you have created with an attribute employee ID and it is in a small letter, and another update command or get command where you are putting attribute name is equal to employee ID, and if you put there as a capital, it will not work. It will say that the given schema doesn't exist. So that is important. While giving the attribute name is case sensitive. So if here I have given the first name as for the range, and the first name is an attribute name for the range key column. So F is capital, N is capital. So important, these are the important things. Now once we define the attribute definitions, key schema, then we define the attribute definition. So employee ID, attribute type is number. Now attribute name is first name, attribute type is syntax. Then provision throughput, read capacity 1, write capacity unit 1, table, this is just an get update. You will come to know table meta client get waiter, table exist, wait, table name is again employee, print item count. So this is the code we are going to run. So this is the code. Like, suppose you have written the code and save in somewhere in a local folder. So you have to give full path from the command line. Here, because my AWS is already installed, say AWS S3 LS, if I type, means my user is already working. Now I will run this. Python capro AWS CLI command is create table. So imply table I am going to create. Click here. It will give 0, means it got successful. See, if we will go to DynamoDB and we refresh it, see, the employee, it has come, overview, item, we'll see this. We have employee ID and the first name. So this is the way the table will get created. Now table is got created. Second is, insert the record. How will do the insert? Insert is nothing, it's a put command. See, the put item will work as an insert as well as for the update. What does that mean? Yes, there is the same command, put item. But put item, if it is a new item, it will put it Okay, if you want to put some condition, you can put within the item. It will check for the condition and then it will update the new attribute value for the column. We'll see that. So very simple, I told you, import Boto3 DynamoDB, two line is always there, table name, because for imply table we are going to do, and the table put item imply id is 101 with first name, this two is always present, this I have added, last name is first name is Biju Thomas, last name, see this L is not capital, it is small. So whenever you define the attribute name, be clear, it is case sensitive like your data. Age is 35, role is IT administrator, we'll do that, we'll run that also. So we'll run that command, go to the command line and see. It's already inserted. How? We'll refresh it. See. So it's very, very, very simple if you're using a Python code. Similarly, we'll go for update. See the key update item. Okay, sorry, I was not aware. Support item, now it's update item. When key is okay, when you write update item, just I want to clarify, we have to always put this key columns, the primary key and the short key, and then we have to put the update expression, set age is equal to new value, expression attribute value where value is equal to, so the imply id is 001 where the value is age is 35, see this age is 35, I want to update the age with 36. So we can do that. See, simple. So what I will do is, I have just, because I have already updated, I will update it. We'll go here and refresh it. See, 36. Now one thing will miss, how to fetch the record, select statement. We run the select statement. Will give here the data. See, so what was present in the select statement? So in the select statement, I told you again, import Boto3 DynamoDB is equal to Boto3 dot resource DynamoDB. If you are doing for the same table, table is equal to DynamoDB dot T capital table, and the table name is implied. Now response table get item. So when you type a get item, that is also important. If you want to fetch a record, if you are putting a get item, you have to put in a condition is only either a primary key or the short key. Okay, so we'll run that, and when we run with imply id is 001 and first name is Bizu, see this last name Thomas, role is IT administrator, Bizu is decimal, all will got here. Similarly, if you want to delete the record, very simple, we can delete the record, we can delete the record. And what is present in a delete? So in the delete, see this table dot delete item, that is also packages key. So when you get item and the delete item, you have to define the key value. Without key value, it will not work. Okay, and this two line, import Boto3 DynamoDB is equal to Boto3.resource DynamoDB. This two line is always present. And if you are working for the same table, the table is equal to DynamoDB.tableName. Here the T is capital. And imply ID. And key, whatever the, which are the column is present as a key column. You put the key, attribute name and the value. And see this. We'll go here and see in the command line, data has gone. Now we have deleted, we'll do the batch write. Batch means writing more than one update, put record more than one. So again it is BOTO3. DynamoDB is equal to BOTO3 zero resource. This two line is always present there working for the same table, then three line will be always present with table dot batch writer as batch. So batch dot put item, that was only the change with the normal put item and the batch write. So this line will be an extra. Put item will be same is equal to item. Now here you can put column is employee ID is 111, account type first name, last name, age, address. So I have created some records and we'll run that. Batch right. We'll again run that. See. If we will go and refresh here, see this. Employee ID 00123. First age, last name, Thomas. See, address is also present in a mapping. Right? Like city is Bangalore, country is India, road 7, all this record is present here. All this record is present here. Now, we have done the sum load. Now, how we can create a loop? Yeah, we'll see that. Suppose I have to upload the 50 records. What I will do is we'll run the loop. How we can create a loop, we'll see that. I told you import BOTO3, DynamoDB is equal to BOTO3 through resource, DynamoDB, table name is equal to DynamoDB dot table name in employee. This three line is always common. With write, batch write, we'll do only the batch write for the loop. Just we'll write a simple concept, but the syntax is a bit different. For I in the range of 50, batch put item, account type anonymous, employee ID 004, integer, because if it is a string, it will type a string plus I, so it will plus one, it will add in first name and the last name. I have just given the same. We cannot give employee ID same because, you know, it is a unique primary key in the DynamoDB, so it cannot accept, it will throw error. So we'll run the loop. Now interesting part is when we run the loop, you'll see that there will be a 50 record will come here. See this. See. It will be a 50 records. But did you find anything difference? Yes. The data I loaded through the loop, it has only 4 attributes. And the data I loaded through the batch has a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 attributes. Means that every row, the attribute value attribute is dynamic. That is called dynamic schema. Most of the NoSQL databases has. So the DynamoDB also has. Am I right? In our RDBMS environment, if you have a one table has a six columns, if inserting a row, it has a 4 column. One row doesn't have any column. Any value, it will either throw an error or it will take as a null value. Here it is not a case like that. Every row or you can say item can have its own set of attributes. So the last data I loaded through a loop is it has only the employee ID, attribute, first name, the last name. They are not bothered about the address and all. So dynamically you can upload the record. Now the next part is that query. How will query the records? So using a query you can do with a two way. Either hash value or some other expression. See, the one line will get extra when you try to query it. Import BOTO3. And you have to do the one extra line is from BOTO3 dot DynamoDB dot condition import key and attribute. This extra line will be added in the code. DynamoDB is called to BOTO3 dot resource DynamoDB means which resource the BOTO3 has to work. So we are defining DynamoDB and then which table the DynamoDB dot table and the table name. So I think this first third and fourth line is always clear. The second line we have introduced from here is import the key and attribute. Now the response is called to table.query, and key condition expression is called to key. The key is a primary key and the short key. Okay, so we can change it. We can, it's nothing to bother about. We can change it. We can put, if you want, we can put 002 and Balakrishna. So we can change Balakrishna and 002. We can save this. And now we'll run that. This output will come here on the screen only. See this. I run the code, so we'll got address is called to country is called to India, road is called to MG Road, city Hyderabad, state Telangana, last name Palani, account type IT administrator, first name is Balakrishna, age is 32, employee ID 10002. We can check that. Now important point is, if I have to put attribute value where the attribute is not the part of key columns, right? Suppose I have to, like in our RDBMS database, if you create an employee table, employee ID has a primary key, but I want to search with a first name, it will do whole table scan. So that is called scan if the index is not created. So we'll see the scan. Scan means, see, import BOTO3. Whenever you do the query and scan, this line will be always come. BOTO3 DynamoDB condition, import key and attribute. So four line will be present. The response is called to table.scan. See here the scan, not query. Filter expression, the attribute, the first name begin with R, you can give that there, or is equal to begin with, there are syntax present in that, you can use that. You go in documentation, you will get it. An attribute is account type is support. We'll check that if we have anything with that also or not. So this is belong to name start with R. So we'll start with a name start with an R. So name start with an R, capital R. See this, because we have put a condition, first name is equal to Ram and the account type is support group. So whenever you are putting an attribute which is not the part of key column, you have to use a filter expression. And you have to put the syntax here, scan. But when you're using with the hash range, you have to put key condition expression. And the here is query. This is the big difference between when querying with a hash value, hash attribute, or querying with a non-key column attributes. This is the difference. Now we have done with insert, update, select, delete the record, batch process, search the query, search the record with a syntax, key column, non-key columns, like other attributes. Now how can we delete the table? Very simple. And delete is always very simple. Same first three line, import BOTO3, DynamoDB is equal to BOTO3.resource.DynamoDB, table is equal to DynamoDB.table and imply and delete table.delete. It work in a very simple way. So we'll run that. Now we'll go and check it with your, nothing is present here, yeah, because it's giving an error. When we refresh here, employee table has gone. Okay, so what we have seen here, how to create a table, insert the record, select the record, update the record, delete the record, upload the batch process, loop, query with key columns, scan with, or you can say like query with non-key columns or non-key attributes, as well as how to delete the table through the Python code from your local machine. You can communicate. Now, come here and we have discussed about Lambda. So I told you, what is Lambda? Lambda is nothing, is just an utility and service that allow you to run your code without having your infrastructure. I have some code I want to communicate to the application and do the job. I don't have to invoke another server and let's server to communicate with that. So I have to pay for the whenever the server will run. And then for the small code to run for the 5 minutes, every day, suppose 5 minutes I have to run, I have to maintain another server. You can put in Lambda. So whenever the code will execute, only you have to pay for the execution time. So it's a very big game changer. You can save a lot of money for the small code you want to communicate to the main application. Similarly, suppose, see the example here. Suppose I have a DynamoDB running in my AWS environment and I need some Python code to work on it. What I will have to do if the Lambda is not there? I have to invoke an EC2 server. I have to install all the Python code and all the required things. Then I have to check the EC2 server is able to communicate through my DynamoDB table or not. And then I will run my code, put in the script, and then I have to schedule it. But it has to run every day for half an hour or 20 minutes. But my EC2 server will be run continuously and I have to pay for that. To avoid that, I can use Lambda. What is the Lambda? Very simple. You have to go and create as a create function my test table. I'm just giving an example. So the function is, I'm giving just name my test table creation. Okay, runtime. On which kind of the development environment you want to run this function? So I have to choose Python because I have written my code in a Python. I will click here. And then permission, like what you want to do. Once I will write my code will go and create a table in DynamoDB. So choose here the role. Before that, you can also go to the IAM console and create a role. You can give whatever the name role you want to give. Create a role, and in the role assign a policy, which is you can just assign the policy to do the all the admin work of DynamoDB. That's simple. That you can do it. So I have already created a role. So I will click here. See this, create DynamoDB DynamoDB table Lambda. This code I will click here. And the one function will be get created. Once the function will be get created, see this, import JSON, import JSON, because this is just a dummy code has been given. Import JSON, I can put import Boto3. Simple. Now I have already written a code. I just wanted to copy and paste here. Don't worry, I will give all the code in as a link and you can download it. See, what is the difference between the code I have written in my Python code written from to run from the local machine? This is the difference. After import Boto3, this line will be always present in all the code. And the second, you have to define the which region you are going to create. Very simple. wherever you are now, you have been logged into Lambda, same reason please give it while creating the DynamoDB table. If you will not give, it will run, it will give a lot of error, you will not able to find. It will say table exists, but table would be not exist somewhere. Second important, to write this code, it's better to use, if you are a developer and if you are you are very well known, or even you have know somewhat in Python, please use Python PyCharm and put this definition def lambda handler there as a copy paste, because this def lambda handler event content will generate its own format. See this, even I remove this from here to there, it throw that there is some error. You will never come to know where the error is, and it is very hard to find. Since morning to till evening, you will not able to find for a simple code where the error is. So always check. Whenever the something bracket is closed and open, you try to hit enter and see where the enter is going on, and come the next syntax up to there. So this is the code, very simple. The code is very same. Let me like this. It's not going away. Okay, the code is very same. Only thing is I have introduced this line. After introducing this line, I have to do copy paste or every line. Just typing or write copy paste will not work. Each and every line you have to check, because it generates its own format. See this. If it doesn't generate the format, then it will throw error. Now we can save it. So you have created a function, and you tell the lambda that function is going to run on a Python code, and then you can assign a role to the is function, because the role was already created. Otherwise you have to create a role, because what the code is going to do, according to that you have to create a role in the code. I want to create a table and do the operation on a DynamoDB table. That's the reason I created a role with a DynamoDB, created a role where I have attached the policy to which work with a DynamoDB. So this is done. Now there is something called event. For every function you have to create an event. Event is like my, because nothing is coming as an input, but we just have to write my test DynamoDB event and just save it, create it. It's nothing going to harm. Now see this, I have Boto 3, only extra line is added. Now the code is entirely same, and then we'll test it. See, your program executed successfully because I have given in the return. Now we'll go to the DynamoDB. That's a beauty. See, implied table got created. I have shown this only for the first of the how the function will get created. So if you go to the here in a function, I have already created all the functions. So if you go to the create DynamoDB table, this we have, I have already created that, because that, but just to show you how to create a function, I follow the process. Now once you create the function, how to load data, we'll click here and we'll see that what are the code written here. Import Boto 3, definition is called to lambda handler, this again come, then DynamoDB is equal to Boto 3 resource DynamoDB and my table DynamoDB. Let me write. See this. Now the import Boto 3 define lambda handler, it will be always present. Whenever you write any code for the Python from the lambda side, you have the second line is always required. Then DynamoDB is equal to Boto 3 resource DynamoDB table. My table is equal to DynamoDB dot table imply. See this, that E is a capital. Here I have a single, I have to put record. I'm not running in a batch, so I will test it. Your data has been loaded. Sorry, I'm in here on it. So I can go there. Okay, let me, because to show you, I increase that. Okay, we'll go to the item part. And see this, I've already inserted some records. So this is the way. First, I shown you how to create a function in Lambda, and then you copy paste your code which you have written to the function. Now go to the function here. Now we have inserted the record. We can select function. Select function also. I have import Boto 3 defined Lambda. This line will be similar, the all four line. And the rest of line is only the second line is differ from the code which we are running from our local machine. So response is equal to get item key column, because in this table I have put key column is employee ID and salary, and see this employee ID is in capital letter because the key attribute name itself is in capital letter. How? Check here, employee ID is in capital letter. So if I will write in a small letter, it will throw an error. If you want to show that, imp_id, let's save it and test it. See. An error occur while calling the loop. The provided key element does not match the schema. Okay, if I put it capital one, if I put it capital one, see, your data output has come. Last name is Swami, salary is this, first name is Bala, employee ID is 100513, department ID is 10, department is HR. So these are the bill output has come here. So similarly, I told you if you remove that, the syntax should be same in attribute name. It should be, if it is in capital, it should be in capital. If it's small, it should be in small. It's a case sensitive. If first letter is capital, first letter should be capital while writing your code. So select function is also we have done, load is done. And what we can do is we can query with we can do the batch load. For the batch load also I have created the batch load function, action, view detail. See this, it's present here. Similarly, define Lambda handler event and content, because this line is important. After import Boto 3, if you put this line, then it will generate a kind of format, and if anything is miss from the format, then you are a gone case. It will take every syntax you have to check. So it's better if you want to deploy in a production, you go for every line, even some 100 line of code, you check it, test it, and then keep as it is as a Python code, and then whenever required you can run it. So we can run this, we can test it, and we can refresh here. See, all new address has come for the new record. For the lower record means dynamic, item is dynamic using the Python code, we can check that. Now we have already written the another function, the same code is there, only this the define Lambda event is there. Query with column, everything we have seen. Now we can check with the loop function also. So loop function means it will go with a 50, and then we can test it. When you click on a test, it will execute and execution will be completed here in DynamoDB table. See this. Now see how many record we have. Balakrishna first name, Ramanujam Balakrishna, Ramanujam Balakrishna, have created. Employee ID I have just put plus I, so it will 250 it will generate. So in through the Python code using Lambda, we can see how to do then insert, update. Okay, if you want to check update, we can check the update statement also. Okay, update I have not written, so no problem. It's very similar. Only that line we need to add it, because writing every code and creating and showing in is very lengthy and it will be time taking. So I have just shown you first function, like how to create it. Code is already present, and after that how you can run the other code. So now we can do it, delete function. So delete function is a delete table or delete record. So if it is a delete function, so it will be deleted. So it is done. Now if you go and check, the employee ID is not there. (5331) is not there. It is not there. 5051 is not there. Similarly, we will go to the function, and then we can run as a delete table function. So using the delete table, what we can do is we can test it. Same code, whatever we have shown you, the same code is present here. Only thing is that that extra line, the for the Lambda event, the line is present. Now it will throw some error. Yes, similar to that. Yes, we come here and we see that the table has gone. So we have seen how we can create a table using the Lambda code. Either you can run from your local machine or run from your Lambda, Python code using the Lambda or through the local machine using AWS command line. We have seen how to create a table, how to insert the record in the table, how to delete it, how to update it, how to query based on key columns, how to query based on non-key columns, how to delete the record, and how to delete the table. Now, lab part is done. Only important part we have to keep is like, what are the exact syntax difference in the Python code when you are running through the Lambda and we are not running through the Lambda, you are trying to run through your local machine. Second important is format. When you try to run the code through the AWS Lambda, the code should generate in the proper format which Lambda event content format it generates. If it will be mostly error, 99% error when you write the same code, the error will come. It mostly related to the two reasons. Either you have logged in one region and try to create table in another region, it will throw error, or the format is not correct. So better you go and do the typing rather than copy paste. Or if you want to do the copy paste one by one line in a PyCharm code, and then try to take it out the code and run in the Lambda. And that point of time you will come to know which line has an issue. It is very easy to catch it. So you can write a proper code which can run in Lambda. That's only advice from my side. Now, the next topic we are going to discuss about is load and unload data from S3 to DynamoDB and integration of DynamoDB table with other AWS services. What are the other AWS services we can integrate our DynamoDB table and lab on it. Hope you have liked this session of the CRUD operation. Thank you. Let's keep learning. If you have any feedback, please write us to feedback@capro.co.in. Apart from that, you can learn, if you want to learn, You can blockchain, cloud, data science, ETL, data lake, DevOps, big data testing, and cloud testing. Please follow us on YouTube, Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter. You can also, we have a Twitter handler called AWS Capro. You can ping us, message us if you have any query or any consultation required. You can ping us there. Thank you. Let's keep learning.